Here is our second video where Aubrey is reading for Earthworm and Spider, Meg for Centipede and James, and Anna for Ladybug and Old Green Grasshopper. Aubrey's first choice is Earthworm, Meg's is Centipede, and Anna's is Ladybug, but they're reading for several parts just so you get a feel of their versatility.
Look who's here.
We've been waiting for you.
Oh no, no.
I'm hungry.
I'm famished. So am I.
Everyone is famished. We need food.
Aren't you hungry?
What's the matter with you? You look positively ill.
He looks like he's about to faint.
Oh my goodness, the poor thing. I know what it is. I do believe he thinks we're going to eat him.
Oh no, silly thing. What an awful thought.
You mustn't be frightened, dear. We wouldn't dream of hurting you. You're one of us. You're one of us now. Part of the crew, don't you know that? We're all in the same boat. We've been waiting for you all day long. We thought you were never going to make it. Show up. I'm glad you made it.
So cheer up, my boy. Cheer up. Now come over here and help me with my boots. It takes me hours to do this by myself. Thank you so much. You were so kind. Well, you have a lot of boots.
I have plenty of leg feet. 100 to be exact. I am a centipede.
There he goes again, always talking about his feet. He simply cannot stop telling lies about his legs. He's only got 42.
But centipedes have...
They do not. Oh no, people just don't bother to count. There's nothing even marvelous about having lots of legs.
Poor Earthworm. He's blind, you know. He can't see how splendid I look.
In my opinion, the most marvelous, most splendid thing is to have no legs at all and still be able to walk.
Walk, you slither.
I glide.
You, sir, are a slimy beast.
I am not a slimy beast. I am a useful and much-loved creature. Ask any gardener you like, and as for you...
I am a pest.
He is so proud of that. But for the life of me, I cannot understand why. Both of you stop this nonsense. Hello, I'm Ladybug.
Please too. I am the only pest in this room. Unless you count Old Green Grasshopper over there. But he's too old to be a pest anymore.
Young fellow, I'm Grasshopper, who is rather old, but not a pest. I'm a musician.
Well said, Old Green Grasshopper. In case you haven't guessed by now, my name is Spider.
James. Your name is James, isn't it? Yes. Well, James, have you ever in your life seen such marvelous, colossal centipede as me?
I certainly haven't. How on earth did you all get this big?
I certainly haven't. How on earth did you all get to be so big? It was peculiar, very peculiar indeed. I was messing about in the garden when suddenly I saw this green thing wriggling right in front of my nose. I know what that was.
It happened to me too.
And me. Certainly there were little green things wriggling everywhere. The soil was full of them.
I actually swallowed one.
So did I.
I swallowed three. And who's telling the story here, huh? Stop interrupting.
Not right now, Centipede. Why don't you get to the top and get started?
What's going on?
We are about to leave this ghastly hill that we have all been living on for so long. We are about to roll away on this magnificent peak and go
where?
Never you mind. You are coming with us. No more living with two repulsive aunts of yours.
Here, here.
We are going to roll right down this hill, roll right over a cliff and land directly into the sea, James. The only thing that was stopping us was you and the stem of this peach. Now you're here.
And I've just finished. I've chewed right through the stem. We're off. Let the journey begin.
And who knows where it will end. If you had anything to do with it, it can only mean trouble.
Nonsense. We are going to visit marvelous places and see wondrous things.